They are only the partners who are going to give you these awards. Yeah, come on. Well, amazing. Thank you. I can see a lot of energy inside in this room. And this is really nice to see all this charged up audience now. So as you all are aware that Neon Events is a property of Exchange for Media Group. And way back, it has been started in 2000. And of course, as you are aware, since then, it has become one-stop platform for all the business in media marketing and advertising. With many a marquee event under Exchange for Media's banner, Neon Events has become synonymous to the best in the out-of-home industry. To formally welcome you all, I now invite Dr. Annurag Batra, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief of Exchange for Media Group and Business World. May I have a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, once again for the gentleman, Dr. Annurag Batra.
Sneha, good evening. Please give Sneha a big round of applause. It's the Women's Day. That's why we obeyed all those things. You asked us to go left, right, up, down. So we did all that because it's Women's Day. It's my honor and privilege to be here. I just want to say that I feel very happy today about the OH industry and neons, because this is an industry I briefly worked. I was with J. Walter Thompson and I briefly worked in the OH industry. And again, it is very customary to beat ourselves. We are not good at this, we are not good at that. But I can tell you, in the last 16, 17 years of Exchange for Media and seeing the media industry, seeing the out-of-home industry, today the quality of conversations, and I was there for a little while, I was not there in the room, but I can tell you the energy I got, the kind of conversations, the kind of people, I think the out-of-home industry has definitely become more professionalized. So I just want to start by saying that. You know, it is better quality of people. We have been talking about measurement. We've been talking of accountability, creativity. I think finally I see a lot of that here. So I just want to start by saying that you should applaud each one of yourselves for making this industry what it should be and what it can be. So I'd like to start with that. Please give yourself a big round of applause. Second, I'd like to welcome, you know, the all Exchange for Media events are only about the jury process. They're about the jury, they're about integrity. There are people who have not participated this year because they wanted guaranteed awards. We don't do that. We don't do that. I cannot guarantee award to Nawal. Nawal cannot guarantee an award to me, right? And our team is there, they sit through the jury, they know how honest it is, they believe in it. We don't even know who the winners are, except people awards. I think that's the only two categories I sat in. So I really want to use this opportunity to welcome our jury chair, Mr. Rakesh Kaul, who is the CEO and president of Hindware. So Mr. Kaul was one of the most democratic and pleasant jury chair. So please give him a big round of applause. I also see a lot of other jury members, and I welcome all of you. I also want to use the opportunity to welcome Mr. Prem Shankar Jha, whose presence here adds the regulatory, government, you know, supply side, policy side dimension. I'd also like to welcome Armino, who in some way represents the quality of professionals that came into the OH industry and made a contribution. Would like to welcome my friend Amit Tiwari. Amit, again, somebody who been part of very large businesses and brands and does plays a large part in making sure that the practices in our industry keep pace with the changing consumer habits. I'm very happy today. This is a very close friend of mine. As we grow, we forget our old friends. We get too busy with whatever we are doing. And now my friends are people in the media industry. I meet them. But one of my classmates, Nawal and me went to the same engineering school. Nawal is two batches junior to me. Ravish is my batchmate and friend. He's an entrepreneur, runs a garment brand called Elsie. Ravish and his friends are here. So I'm very happy. Ravish has never come to an event of mine in 20 years, 18 years. So Ravish, welcome. And I just want to say that the three things that differentiate our awards, I have a running nose, got too much air conditioning in the hotel last night. And also welcome our friend and somebody who's a partner in lots of our initiatives as an organization. I want to welcome Mr. Jalan of Lakshya, who's been kind enough to see merit in whatever we do and professionally partner with us and believe in us. So really, I want to say that there are too many awards happening. Even in the OH domain, there are more than three awards. the four differentiators we bring to the awards are, one, we are a leader brand in this space. I don't want to go on saying too much, but whatever we do it with passion, and the industry totally patronizes us. So we have a locus standi to give an award. We editorially report on this domain. We don't report enough on OH. We should do more, and we will. Second, we do it through a jury process. So absolutely, honestly, Amit is here, Mr. Setia from, you know, Amit, you're here. Amit met me yesterday. He met me last week. I told him that next 30 days we won't meet. Don't miss me too much. So, you know, all the jury members are here. We do it absolutely honestly. No quid pro quo, no suggestions, no prompting. There's a process, there are entries, there's data, and then there's the jury. And a lot of people call me saying, you know, in the Business World Awards, Exchange for Media, I'm entering. So I say, I'll pray for you. That's the only thing I can do. So when you win an award tonight, it has come through a process where marketeers, media leaders who actually put money in media and OH have taken very elaborate calls based on data, based on their understanding. Third, at the end of the day, we have the ability to showcase work, amplify this work. And last, we deliver more marketeers. The whole objective when we curate our events is to be able to bring people who are in the marketing ecosystem to every domain. So look at the number of marketeers in the jury. Look at the number of marketeers that have spoken during the day. So really, that's what we bring to the table, and that's what makes it what it is. So thank you for making the Neons and OH Awards what they are. I've said this before, I wrote a piece 12 years back in Pitch, and I don't know where is Alok Gupta of Graphics. I saw him in, Alok is a young friend of mine, his dad, Mukesh is a friend of mine, he was my neighbor. And I was in Cannes attending one of the early years I started going to Cannes, and I'm sleeping, and I'm getting calls after every 3 minutes from Mukesh ji. So finally I picked up the call, said, I'm in France and it's late night here, can I call you back? He said, nee, mereko aapse baat karni hai. Aapne ek article likha hai Pitch mein, and you've talked about the caste system in media, and you called the out of home guys Shudras. I mean, I didn't call it Shudras, but I mean, it kind of read like that. But point I was trying, that it was low in the value chain. I don't think with the amount of money being spent, the integration of technology, the integration of experiential, OH has really come a long way. I really feel happy seeing the quality of conversations. It still has a long way to go, but I think it has progressed. So that's what I'm particularly happy. At the end of the day, we are a catalyst in showcasing good people, leaders who made a difference. And tonight, the two leaders who will be awarded are leaders who in some way are pioneers in what they've done. They've not gone down the beaten track. They continue to innovate, and they've set examples in the way they've led their companies and institutions, and they've contributed to the industry. So the two people awards and awardees that you see tonight are a reflection of the evolution of the OH domain. So I wish you all the best. I hope this domain grows, it integrates well. There's more professionalism, there are more ethics, because really that will grow the domain. It's Women Day, and I can say that every day in our life is Women's Day. Married people, I mean, that's what I'm talking of. So, but on a serious note, I just want to say that Business World, we've done a survey where the number of women every year in the last 10 years in entrepreneurship is growing. And that's a very healthy trend. The only thing I want to say, that we are doing it on a Women's Day, but the number of women in leadership positions in OH is still low. I know at Group M's OH agency, Kinetic, there are two CEOs and one of them is a woman, right? That's welcome. And when you think of leadership, you don't think of gender. You think of ability. You think of, you know, the drive. Whether you're a man or a woman doesn't really matter. In Exchange for Media, I think the women number outnumber the men. Four of our editors are women. Three of our business heads are women. Except me, Naval, Nishkal and Gaurav. Everything is, you know, everybody is led by women in our company. So the only thing I want to say on the Women's Day is, I hope in the OH industry, we see more women in the leadership position running companies, and I'm sure it will happen as the number of women in leadership positions across the industry is growing. So I just don't want to stand between you and the awards. I want to thank the jury chair who spent so much time, all the jury members who spent so much time making the decisions tonight. This year we had 250 plus entries. We have 52 awardees between various categories. Two people awardees as part of those 52. I'm told by both the Priyankas that all of them are here. I couldn't make it in the morning because flights got rescheduled. I was coming from Bombay, but I referred to a young man, and he's not even a sponsor of our event, Gautam of Bar Talk. I don't know where he is. Maybe he's already at a bar. But he's a very good example of how he's integrated technology into OOH. How two-way conversations. So that's how OOH is changing. Entrepreneurial energy is changing the OOH domain. So on this day of Women's Day, and a day that is always about entrepreneurship, because the OOH domain is most number of entrepreneurs, people who pick up rights, people who create new opportunities using technology. We'll continue to evolve in our nuance, and we ideally want to make it a two-day event, and we want to do it twice a year. So I hope we can do it beyond one day. Throughout the day, again, we've had five sessions, three keynotes, and all of our speakers, I'm told, made an impact. I was not in the room, but I was getting SMSs from people in the room. So I wish you luck. I congratulate all the winners. I congratulate all the shortlisted entries and institutions. And I wish you luck for the coming year. Since I represent the media industry, I want to finish by saying there is a fight for the soul of our country happening. I'm not a political person. I'm not in any party. I'm too undiplomatic to be in a political party. I look down on politicians in some way, but politicians are a necessity. Parties are a necessity. Governance is a necessity. But I just want to say that in next few months, 2 months, there will be an election. So just don't feel and vote. Think and vote. I just want to say that. Whoever you believe in, do ask the right question. And the environment is being made such that media are being asked to answer questions, which is also okay. We should be accountable. But if something happens, the people who are doing that are not being made accountable. News guys are being asked, how did you get the information about that? I think that's a very dangerous trend. And again, you know, I have lots of respect for our Prime Minister. He's very, very entrepreneurial. He's done lots of good things. But all governments are oppressive. They don't want the truth. All. The last government, this government. So I hope all of us as citizens and people from the media can have the spine to stand up and say, this is wrong. Because really, otherwise, the democracy that we've thrived in won't last. And we shouldn't idolize our politicians. Politicians are not normal people. They're special people. But we shouldn't idolize politicians. We shouldn't put them on pedestals. Like we put our news anchors on pedestals. Satya, I'm referring to you. We shouldn't put politicians on a pedestal. They're here to do a job, and let's make them accountable. So I want to use every platform that I go to say this, that please don't feel and vote, think and vote. As in, whoever you want to vote for, I would not be upset even if you vote for Kejriwal. Though I should be upset, but I'm just saying that, you know, there are other entertainers that you can vote for. He may not be the one that you want to vote for. Thank you.